Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind for the Commodore Amiga. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We should now be able to get through this door with the following... That music is insane. Or... I don't even know if I would call it music. Selection of sounds. It just makes me... It's funny because it brings out a feeling of uneasiness in me. Which, maybe it's meant to do that. I don't know what I'm doing here. Security card class C. Now if we just hit open, yeah, it won't work. You gotta use the item. This is, this is use the item. I don't know what that's supposed to be. Because it looks like this hammer, but on its side. And outlined. As you insert the security card, the door silently opens. No, it did not silently open. It went vroom, like that. I beg to differ. Do we still have the card? I guess that's been used up. We still have the Class A card, which we haven't used anywhere yet. Okay. This is weird video game logic where keys get used up. You're like, they get stuck in the lock. This special store seems to be done for some special reason. I'm not completely sure what you mean by that. But there's something ahead. It's a Scorpion machine gun with plus 15 ammo. I like that. I don't know who can use it. Gotta analyze it. Oh. And we have Scorpion clip 15 quantity. Resource detail. Okay. How much can you carry, big guy? Alright. Alright, let's examine this thing. Alright, network. This is how you get stats of things in this game. It's 30 kilograms. Okay. It requires a minimum of 50 strength. To do what? Carry it around? We're gonna use it somehow? Oh. No idea actually what it is. Alright, so we'll put that back. Scorpion clip. Scorpion machine gun, 3.85 kilograms. All classes can use. Average wounding is 30. Range is 16. And it has 15 ammo. 30 and 16 range. And some other stats. Well, it's good to hear that anyone can use it. But I want to compare to the other gun. Well, that's a crossbow. He's not even using a gun. Better off with the gun. I think the shotguns we have, or carbines, they're even more, like, they're more deadly than the crossbows. But I'll take a look at it. Wounding. Range 10. Yeah, it's much better. Requires perception of 30. Well, I think I'm gonna give him this gun then. Let's analyze this. I know after last episode there was a whole lot of analyzing of items. Now we got some more to look at. Wounding is 28, range 16. Yeah, it's the best weapon. It's the best, this is the best weapon here. And he has the crossbow with a tiny bit of ammo. Do they have more ammo? Oh yeah, just as well. Does that have bolts, I guess? Okay. That's good to me. Checking nothing else, right? Okay. Alright, so that's what was hiding in here. Resource detail and that gun with ammo. So we're done here. We have two other ladders to explore. Let me get this thing. There's this advent as I believe. Yeah. Let's see if we can sense anything. This is supposed to pick up traps. This ladder leads to emergency tunnel number 2. The detector remains quiet. It looks like there's no danger here. I'm gonna save just in case, because I have famous last words. And up we go. There's an emergency ladder next to you. Okay. You are now in maintenance sector 1. A hollow gate door is here. Oh! Yeah, I don't trust that yet. Is this where he came from? No, no, no. I know where we are. Now we're back up here. Okay. That's good to know. That's where the teleporter number 1 brings us. I think. Ladder that way. Did it just go in a big circle? I think it did. Not exactly a circle, but it looped back. It seems like this corridor hasn't been used for ages. Well, because there's nothing here for anyone to get. That would be why. Just an empty room. You are standing beside a simple-looking electronic unit. I am. Nothing we can pick up, I guess, so we're not detecting any objects. Maybe we're supposed to use the card there? The other card? Nothing special happens at all. It won't open. Alright, well, we're just gonna try items. Nothing happened there. So maybe one of the other things we've gathered. The resource detail. I don't know what the resource detail is. Nothing special happens at all. At all. It doesn't want that. What else has some of these things, like this thing? Holo scan device? Nope, alright. That thing? Interrupter plug? If that doesn't work, then there's nothing else. No, huh? I do not like that. Maybe we'll try to use the card on the door anyway, although you're probably supposed to use that device. Just checking. What else? Maybe the interrupter plug on the door? But let's try this first. Since I'm... got it. Claw doesn't have anything. I think it's Advent who has that. Right. Oh. I got no message at first. I thought something was about to happen. Oh well. I probably have to come back here. And get something maybe down one of the other tunnels. I like this, how you have this central area downstairs with like all these ladders up. It's a really good exploration, I think. It's fun. Alright, so... we cannot get there yet. Maybe we gotta defeat someone else and get their key card. Some wires are dangerously hanging out here from an open panel. Well, that's an invitation. Start using the stuff over here. Nothing special. Well, you keep giving me ideas, like I'm gonna get somewhere. And just nothing happens, oops. We use a weapon on the wires, destroy it so we can get in the door. I don't know. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to look at all their stats. Oh, I forgot the rest also. Let's do that now. Yay. Cool. So, Killdozer's stamina, 137, how about that? Vitality is 95. Pretty good stuff. Perception, 92. I mean, those latter two might have been there already like that. Epsilon's stamina is 141, and his speed is 187. 92 vitality, 80 strength, 97 dexterity. He is really good stats right now. Relatively, yes, constitution, but constitution you can only get up to, for a lot of members, I think 40 for some of them, 20 for one or all the chimeras. You can only go to 20, I believe, with constitution. Perception's 91. And then Twin Snake with 137 stamina, 108 vitality. 94 dexterity. And Rune Claw. His concentration's 108. That's good. That's really good. I think we can cast more spells. I'm not sure. I think mental attack, defense, rates. I'm not completely sure, but I think intelligence is how many spells you can cast, and concentration is how deadly, or more effective, in some cases, the spell is. Don't quote me on that. But I think that's what's like. Yeah, he has horrible constitution because he's one of the chimeras. Yeah, his constitution. Man, we need to get his stamina up. Speed, though, is 127. So he can run away quicker. And Advent with 93 stamina. Still a horrible speed, but better than what it was. 98 intelligence, that's pretty awesome. Alright. So what else can we try? Who had that? There's one other thing, we tried that. Didn't we try this thing already? I think we did. We did. That's the resource detail. I think I tried all the three kind of electronical machine parts we have. Alright. Yeah, we gotta come back. Thought we could do something with the wire. Yes. Security ladder is right where we left it. Emergency tunnel number one. And you notice each one is like more, like, the ones down there have little tunnels in. That one just has one square in, and this one's just right here. I'm not sure if that means anything or anything. Looks like there's no danger here. Alright, I'm gonna save just in case. Save early, save often. Because one of these we went into and it just instantly killed us. You're now in Sector 3. Oh goody. Well, it seems this is a part of the development staff quarters. Indeed. But why say well like that? It rolled up silently. By the gods! A brutally boweled man is lying in that hologate. Boweled? You mean disemboweled? I don't know how you would be brutally boweled. I don't think boweled is even a word. Here's another door. Here. Another door. At least these open. That's something. This small room shows signs of heavy struggle with something beastly. Alright. Well, the beastly thing left something behind, then. Oh, nice. We got another one of those scorpion machine guns. Sweet. Who should get that? I guess whoever's using a crossbow. Because the crossbows are the weakest ranged weapon. So we've already replaced Killdozer's crossbow. He's got the carbine. He's also got the carbine. He's got a shotgun. And he has a shotgun. So I'm gonna replace this thing. Let's put that back. Put that in there. Done. 15 ammo. Alright, no ammo this time. Beastly. Ghastly. A door and a dead end. Okay, heavy military boots. Sweet. Now, I think some of us have those. Wait. Is that what I wanted to do? Right, Epsilon has them. As well as Twin Snake. The rest of everyone else don't have. Stealth boots. That's all? Okay. Alright, let's see. Well, first let's see who can use it. I don't know if he can even use it for some reason. I always wondered why he had stealth boots. I mean, he's a... what is he again? On the other paper. I mean, I could easily look it up. Ah, found it. Okay. He's an assassin. Oh, I guess that's why, to sneak up on your enemies. But we don't... really need to be. We can't sneak up on them, at least as far as I know. Alright, well, let's see if you can even use it. Mediator, Psionic, Knight, and Mercenary. Mediator. Look at that list again. Turn this around. Okay. So, yeah, he can't use it. What's his name? Twin Snake can use it. He already has it. Bionecron Knight. Epsilon. And Twin Snake. They both have them already. A Psionic, though, does not. And Mediator can even use it. So our Chimeras, one of our Chimeras can make out with the deal here. Alright, these modifiers. That's good, no negative on anything. But we've examined these before, because we've... you know, some of us have them. And at one point I went around and... I analyzed everything that everyone had. Alright, so light leather boots and light leather boots. So if we analyze these, yeah, physical protection is plus 2. And has some resistance, but not as good. Plus 2, you said, right? Yeah, plus 10. From 2 to 10. That's pretty awesome. Alright. Giving it to Runeclaw, because, Varanus hides a lot, so he's not going to get a lot of action out of the boots, hiding like that. I think I'm mostly going to keep him around for, like, just healing people. He gets shot once, that's it. I don't know. I want to build up his stamina, too, but I don't think I can do that without him getting into physical combat in the first place. It's a whole catch-22 situation. Alright, well, there's no more place left for that item. Hopefully someone still has it, yeah. Alright. Oh, wrong person. Alright, we gotta put these back on. I didn't give him over yet, did I? Oh, there you go. It's not the most intuitive interface. You cannot carry more equipment without hindering your party's progress. I guess he still has this, right? Yeah. Can you hold it? Okay. He's not carrying much. I like him having the nunchucks, even though I've never used them. Let's see if we can give this to someone else. You want more nunchucks here? I'm having trouble here. Got it. Nice. Alright, so the endurance bar. Oh, wait a second. Endurance level. Oh, 95%. Look at that. So Killdozer can carry some more. Epsilon can carry plenty more. Twin Snake, the most so far. Runeclaw is basically full. Varanus can carry a lot more. And Advent can carry a lot more. Huh. Okay. Looking at something. Oh, okay. I know where we are. Well, we still have to figure out what's going on with that ladder. This one. Can't get past that door. Maybe we have to find it somewhere else. There's also a teleport pad this way. But we'll be reconvening next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.